Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulullah. First of all, just to clarify that I'm not a scholar. I was mentioned in the same sentence as the scholars. I'm a student of knowledge who relays what I learned or what I can remember from what I learned from the scholars. So alhamdulillah. But inshallah ta'ala, what I can remember, I will answer inshallah ta'ala. And regarding the brother's question, your brother asked about those who leave the Salat. He said there's a difference of opinion between the scholars about the ones who leave the Salat. Is he a kafir? Is he a non-Muslim or a Muslim? Obviously, there's a difference of opinion between the scholars about this issue. And then those who say that he's a kafir, they differed. How many prayers does he have to leave to be considered a kafir? Is it one Salat and he's considered a kafir? Or does he have to leave the prayer altogether? First of all, the correct opinion, obviously, is that whoever leaves the prayer is considered a kafir. This is clear from the ayat and from the hadith, two of which I mentioned in the khutbah, and also from the statements of the sahaba, who made it very clear that the one who leaves the salat is considered to be a kafir. And that's why Ibn Abi Malika from the tabi'een, he said that the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't see any actions leaving it to be an act of kufr other than the prayer. So it's the consensus of the sahaba that whoever leaves the prayer is considered a kafir. طيب, now comes the question, how many prayers does somebody have to leave to be considered a non-Muslim? Some scholars said if a person purposely leaves any one prayer until the time leaves, that he's considered a non-Muslim without a valid excuse, that he leaves the fold of Islam. And from the people who see that opinion during our time, from the contemporary scholars, is Sheikh Mbaz, rahimahullah ta'ala. Whoever leaves one prayer on purpose, that he leaves the fold of Islam. Another opinion is the opinion of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, is that whoever leaves the prayer, meaning altogether, that he's considered a non-Muslim. So one who prays sometimes and leaves sometimes, he's in a very dangerous position, but he's not considered a kafir. And this is the opinion that I follow, is that the one who doesn't pray altogether. Or also you can include, as I believe, with these people, the Jum'ah Muslims. The ones who only pray the Jum'ah, I believe they fall into this category as well. And Allah knows best, Allahu A'lam.